Welcome back to All Things Health Podcast. My name is Georgia Overbeck and I'm your host. This is the podcast where we talk about all things health, whether it's physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, whatever it may be. Anything to do with health is what we're going to be talking about here. So today's episode is going to be about things that I do every single day for gut health. So I know that gut health has kind of been like a big trend over the last couple of years, and a lot of people have started talking about it and how to reduce bloating and how to improve digestion. And I really appreciate this trend, I guess, because a few years ago I did go through some gut health struggles myself, and one day I'm going to be doing a podcast kind of about my gut health story and how I healed my gut on my own and how I just improved it so much, because I had some struggles, that's for sure. But I thought today we could quickly talk about things that I do every single day that are kind of easy to implement if you're looking for ways to improve your gut health, just in small ways, and that you can do today. So before we get into that though, we have to do our weekly segments. So every episode we do a movie or what I'm watching or favorite show of the week. And so for this week, it is a movie. I'm going to say a few shows after though as well, because this week all of our shows have come back after being on break for the summer. So we've had some really good shows this week, but we have been watching movies as well. And my favorite movie of this week is called Bringing Down the House. It has Steve Martin in it and Queen Latifah, and it was made in 2003, so it's my age. But it was really funny. It's a good comedy movie. It's not rom-com because there's not much romanticness in it, romance, but it was funny and it had a good story. And so if you're looking for, again, like just a good feel-good movie, I feel like Steve Martin is pretty reliable for that. So that would be my favorite movie of the week. Again, it's called Bringing Down the House. And then I believe it's on Disney Plus if you're interested. And then our shows. The shows that we watch as a family are like 9-1-1, Chicago Fire, Dancing with the Stars, Survivor, Shark Tank, and all of those are back this week, so we have been watching those. I would say that my favorite show we watched this week would be Chicago Fire. I really enjoy that show. If you like firefighter, funny, again, shows, then you would probably like that. So those, I would say, are the favorite things that I've watched this week. Bringing Down the House, which is a movie, and Chicago Fire, which is a show. Now, the second segment of the week is called Recipe of the Week, or my favorite meal, or my favorite snack, or whatever it may be. And this week's favorite recipe is one that I posted, and it is peanut butter and jam chia seed pudding. And hear me out. This is so good. I put up a whole post on my Instagram. I'll link it down below if you want to check out the exact measurements and how to make it. But it's super simple. So it was just chia seeds, protein powder, some non-dairy milk, low sugar jam, and some peanuts. And then you just refrigerate that for a while. And then it was so good. I really, really enjoyed that. So that is definitely my favorite recipe of this week. And it kind of goes well into our theme for this episode, because chia seeds are a very good food for your gut because they are high in fiber. And I just find that when I first started eating chia seeds, they really helped my gut health a lot. So yeah, it kind of is a great recipe because it tastes good and also it's good for your gut health. So we're going to get right into this episode. I'd love to know if you do any of these things, if you're planning on incorporating any of these things. So you can either message me on Instagram, you can comment down below. I'd love to know any of your thoughts on this topic, because when I was going through my gut health journey and struggles, learning these things really, really helped me. And again, even if you're not going through like any struggles right now, I think it's always beneficial to improve your gut health and just your health overall. So these are just little things that I do every single day that help me keep my gut healthy. So also before I get into it, a little disclaimer, I am not a doctor. I have no like certificate or anything in gut health. These are just things that have helped me personally, and that's all I can say. I'm speaking from experience. If you want to talk to a doctor, I mean, that's the best person to talk to, and make sure you're getting good advice from professionals. But you can take anything that I say here with a grain of salt and incorporate if you want, try it out, but don't like take everything that I say super serious, because again, I'm not a doctor in this. So the first tip is eating fermented foods. And I know that this is talked a lot, but every single day I try to incorporate either a yogurt or some soy sauce or some tempeh or sauerkraut or miso, just because those fermented foods are really good for your gut bacteria. I believe they feed the healthy gut bacteria and just help you with better digestion overall. So like, for example, I'll go through how I would include some of these. So I like to have yogurt for breakfast. Often I'll make like a yogurt bowl or a yogurt parfait, or I'll add yogurt into smoothies, or even if you get like a plain yogurt that is not flavored, you can even use that in a lot of savory recipes as well. So sometimes I'll make like a yogurt tzatziki dip, or if I'm making like a taco bowl, I'll add a scoop of yogurt to kind of replace that sour cream for a little bit of extra gut health benefits. But yeah, those are some easy ways to include yogurt in your day. Soy sauce, you could make like salad dressings, you can make stir fries, different dips and stuff like that. Soy sauce is pretty easy. You do want to make sure that you don't have too much, just because it is pretty high in sodium. But if you have a normal amount, then you should be good. Tempeh. I really enjoy tempeh as a main protein source for me as a plant-based eater. So I definitely include tempeh quite a bit. I'll bake it, I'll make a stir fry out of it, I'll put it in like pasta sauce. There's really endless ideas to use tempeh for. If you've never tried it out, maybe this is your sign to try it. And don't think that it's gonna be exactly like meat. If you are a meat eater and you go in thinking it's gonna be like chicken, it's not. It's very different, but it's good, and it's a whole new food to try, and it's good for your gut health. And then another one is sauerkraut. This is kind of like, you know, you can just add sauerkraut to a salad, or if you're making like a Buddha bowl, or if you just have a plate of food, you just add a little scoop of sauerkraut on it. And if you don't like sauerkraut, I challenge you to try it again, because when is the last time that you've tried it? Just have a little bit. You never know. You might like it. I really like sauerkraut, so that's an easy one for me. Miso, you could make miso soup. You could put it into salad dressings, you could put it into stir fries, pretty much the same thing as soy sauce. You know, you could even mix them together for extra gut health benefits. The second thing that I do every single day for better gut health is to eat prebiotic foods. So a lot of people take like prebiotic and probiotic supplements, but if you didn't know, you can get prebiotic and probiotics from food. And so that's just an easier way, I feel, to get it. Of course, taking those supplements are good as well, as we're gonna get into soon. But if you want to, you can even add in extra prebiotic foods just to help extra, you know? So those are things like bananas, asparagus, oats, onions, edamame, cauliflower, garlic, which are easy things to add into your day. Like bananas, you could make a smoothie, you could just eat a banana by itself, you could put it in oats in your yogurt bowl, you could have like a banana yogurt bowl and then add a sprinkle of oats on it or something, and there you go, you've got a perfect gut health breakfast. Asparagus, again, easy, you could just roast it up in the oven, maybe you could make like some sort of soy sauce miso glaze or something, or you can make it a more like Greek style and have asparagus with like yogurt tzatziki on it or something. There's so many options. Oats, that's an easy one. You could just have a bowl of oatmeal, you could bake with them, you could really do anything. It's very, very versatile. And then onions, edamame, cauliflower, and garlic, you could make a beautiful stir fry with those four things. But yeah, so that's just an easy one, is to incorporate more prebiotic foods. If you're interested, you could just Google and see what prebiotic foods are and then try them out. Number three is to eat a variety of plants. And this is kind of goes along with number four, which is diversity. And I think it's important for number three and number four, they're a little different, because number three is specifically of those plants. So fruits and vegetables and whole grains and nuts and seeds, anything that comes from the ground and is a plant, you want to eat a lot of them, and you want to eat a lot of different ones. And that doesn't mean you have to fill your cart every single week with 40 different plants. But you know, like maybe throughout the month, like one week you get bananas, and the next week you get clementines, and then the week after that you get pineapple, and the week after that you get cherries or something, you know? It's just like switching it up every week or as often as you can, really. Maybe every time you go to the grocery store, if you go more than once a week. But eating a variety of plants because they all have different benefits. Some have lycopene in them, some have different vitamins, different minerals, whatever it may be. And so getting that diversity and variety of plants is really good for our guts and our overall health too. And then number four was diversity, which you might be like, isn't that the same as number three? But I think it's a little bit different because it's not only diversity of plants, it's diversity of whatever you may be eating. So that if you are somebody who eats meat, then maybe having chicken one week and then turkey the next and then ground beef the week after that, whatever it may be, pork, just getting that, again, that diversity. And that can be for any like food that you eat, maybe like, I don't even know, but whatever it may be, like plants, meat, what else do people eat? I don't know. But you know, just getting a lot of different fruits and vegetables and meat and eating a diversity. I hope that made sense. The next tip is to avoid artificial sweeteners. Now, a lot of people think, and the thing is, this kind of goes along with avoiding just like very processed sugars in general. But when that happens, a lot of people switch to these artificial sweeteners. So instead of adding regular sugar to your coffee, you might start adding like Splenda or something. Or instead of having chocolate bars, which are high in like processed sugar, you might switch to a protein bar, which is high in artificial sweeteners. And the thing is, everybody's gonna react differently to artificial sweeteners. Some people, they have no problem with it if they eat them like in a normal amount. For me, when my gut health was the worst and I was super bloated all the time and I was constipated and I was just in pain, it was the same time that I was eating a lot of artificial sweeteners. So I would be having like two Splendas in my coffee in the morning, and then at breakfast I would make oats and I'd put like brown sugar alternative on it, or like low sugar, like the Walden Farms maple syrup. And then at lunch I would be adding, you know, whatever, like low sugar ketchup or low sugar barbecue sauce, which was full of artificial sweeteners. And then for a snack in the afternoon, I would have like a protein bar or a bag of like low sugar candy. And then, you know, it just kind of like over the day, it would add up to a lot. Now, if you're having just that like Splenda in your coffee in the morning, or if, even if you have whatever you have during the day and you feel all right, then that's great. But maybe if you have been noticing that you're not feeling your best, maybe try cutting back on those artificial sweeteners a little bit. And you never know, again, as I was saying before, like those artificial sweeteners can be hidden in a lot of things. So it could be like your pre-made oats or your protein bars or like milk, or there's just so many things, like the low sugar anything really, like low sugar candy, low sugar syrups, low sugar barbecue sauce, whatever it is, just take a look and see. So when I started reducing that, I noticed a big improvement in my gut health. So now I try to limit my artificial sweeteners. Of course, I have them every once in a while because they are in a lot of foods. But like, for example, I just have my coffee black now. I don't have any Splenda in it or anything. If I am looking for a little bit of extra sweetness, I'll add a little bit of stevia because I find that that works for me. But you do you. That's just something that I've noticed and that I've incorporated for my gut health. Another tip, number six, is to drink lots of water. I know that we all know we should be drinking lots of water, but I think that this is just a good reminder again. Whenever I drink lots of water, I just feel like so good, you know, like my skin is better. I feel like my digestion's better. Overall, I think we should all be drinking more water. So this is your reminder to drink more water. You can even grab a drink right now if you want to. Number seven is to stay active. I find that if I have some movement in my day, every single day, my digestion is so much better than if I just sat around all day. One of my favorite things to do for digestion is in the morning, I'll wake up, I'll have my coffee, I'll have my breakfast, and then I walk to the gym. And every day when I walk to the gym, I can, like, my digestion is perfect. Like, let me just say that after my walk, every single day, things happen. And if you know what I mean. And so I think that it's just finding like a certain routine that works for you of a time or a certain amount of time that you can work out, or even just go for a walk, because that will help your digestion a lot. Just stay moving throughout the day. Number eight is to limit snacking before bed. Now, this video is just about my experience. You might snack before bed and you feel great. But for me, we usually have dinner at like 7-ish, and then I'm usually in bed by like 9:30 or 10. And so I try to not snack after dinner unless I'm hungry, then I'll snack. Like, there's nothing against snacking before bed. Like, there's no like you're gonna gain 20 pounds if you do that or whatever, or insulin resistance. I just feel better in the morning if I don't snack after I have dinner. I allow my body some time to digest my food before I go to sleep, so that while I'm sleeping, it's not digesting and trying to restore everything else at the same time. So that's something that I try and do. So after I have dinner, usually I'll have a tea because I find that that's really nice. Like, it's nice and soothing on my stomach. It's a nice warm liquid. But again, if I was hungry, I'll eat. But I try to not snack before bed, just to give my body a little bit of a break. But if you want to snack before bed, do it. You could even try, like, for a week, just not snacking before bed and see how you feel. And then number nine, this is kind of a two-part tip, I guess, is to find what makes you not feel good, like certain foods, and then try to reduce them or cut them out completely. So for me, that is dairy. I don't feel good with dairy at all. I've talked about this in my last podcast about my vegan story and why I cut out dairy originally, but it just never was good with my body. I would always be bloated. I was constipated. I did not feel good with dairy, so I decided to cut it out, and I feel so much better. Again, but for you, it might not be dairy. It might be gluten, or it might be a certain fruit or vegetable, or it might be whatever, artificial sweeteners. It could be anything. So just notice what foods make you not feel the best, and then either try to limit them or cut them out. And you could even try bringing them in after not having them for a while, just to make sure. But I think it's good to experiment, see what works for you, see what doesn't, listen to your body. And then the last tip is kind of like an optional one that you don't have to do, but I like to do it. And that is to take certain supplements for gut health. When I say this, I'm not talking about those like gut health cleanse, you know, whatever diuretic things that are horrible. Like, I see those Instagram posts all the time that's like, lose 10 pounds in 3 days or something like that. And it's like, no, that is not what this, no, that's horrible. What I mean is more like natural supplements. So things like, again, as we were talking about before, a probiotic supplement to help your body naturally with digestion. Another one could be like a green supplement. If you are new to this like gut health lifestyle and you want to start eating more food, more fruits and vegetables, more diversity, more fiber, you could try out a green supplement. Or maybe it's glutamine. Glutamine helps with gut health as well. Just taking your vitamins overall, making sure you're getting enough of every vitamin and mineral you need. But yeah, stay away from those like cleanse supplements or like detox. Those are not what I'm talking about. I mean like more natural supplements. If you're interested, you could even message me on Instagram and I can like help you with certain brands or whatever that I like to take. But yeah, again, just do research. Do what works for you. Again, I'm not a doctor. These are just tips that I've included over the last couple of years that have really improved my gut health. When I first got into gut health, I did a lot of research, and I recommend you do the same. So I read a lot of books. I listened to a lot of podcasts. You can watch documentaries, watch YouTube videos. Look even on Instagram at like gut health professionals, not the people that are trying to sell you cleanses or detoxes, but the people who actually put out like great information about certain foods that are good for gut health, or like just actually provide you good information that is going to help you. So that is the podcast for today, all about health, episode 3. I hope that this was helpful. I hope that you learned a few things. Again, I'd love to know if these are things that you already do, if you're going to start including any of them. And as always, if you have any questions, you can message me on Instagram at blondiesbaking_, or you can comment down below and I will respond right to you. Thank you so much for listening, and I will see you next time.